This is Pure American here, and a funny thing happened. Not so funny. But so this morning, woke up at about 4:40-ish, recorded about an hour's worth of video before going to work. Come to find out, so my mic was pretty garbage the last video. It wasn't that it was necessarily garbage, but I didn't have the settings quite right to where you could actually hear me talking. And so I thought, oh, well, when I start recording, I will actually mute the game audio and then start it once the video starts. Well, I don't know if I jacked something up or what, but when I unmuted it, it still didn't pick any of it up. So, unfortunately, I had an hour's worth of me talking and no game audio, and that's kind of boring. So, anyway, to pick up, to repeat myself, like I said, I wanted to start my videos. I wanted to talk about the stuff I had read in the morning during my daily scripture reading, and I'm still reading through 2 Corinthians right now, and I read chapters 11 and 12, and in chapter 11, some of the things that stuck out to me is Paul is talking to them, to the Corinthian church, obviously, and telling them to be aware of false gospels, to be careful of them. And I think that still applies to us a lot today, because there are a lot of false gospels out there, meaning, like, I'm sure some people have heard of the prosperity gospel, meaning come to Jesus and you'll get a brand new car, or he'll be faithful to give you millions of dollars. Well, the Word of God doesn't mention any of that, so it's a pretty false teaching. And also, there are gospels out there that kind of trample grace underfoot, that promise, oh yeah, salvation, but no change. You don't need a change. You can keep sinning, and there's no repentance. And Paul speaks a lot about that too, saying about a godly repentance that will lead to you know, godly sorrow that leads to repentance, and I believe James said the same thing. So, yeah, we need to be diligent on paying attention to people, because Paul also even says that these people who preach this false gospel, a lot of times they'll portray themselves and disguise themselves as servants of righteousness, just like Satan himself disguises. He disguises himself as light, an angel of light, and we need to be diligent of, we don't just need to take everything everybody says just off the bat. When someone is preaching, someone is teaching, we need to be diligent and have our word open and analyzing everything they say compared to the word. And if they are a true preacher of the gospel, they will want you to do that. They won't want you to just accept what they say just because they say it. They should want you to have your word open and analyzing it and growing deeper in it and seeing, okay, yes, they are speaking truth. So that was a pretty good thing I learned from that. And also, at the end of 11 and carrying on to chapter 12, Paul is talking about boasting in his weakness and using that to show God's greatness. So he talks about, he had a thorn in his side, and he had prayed to the Lord 3 times to take it away, but God had responded to him and said, my grace is sufficient for you, and my power is made perfect in weakness. So, something to think about today or throughout the week that is challenging me, that I'm thinking about now after reading that as well, is what are my thorns, or what is my thorn? Like, what is in my side? It doesn't even have to be physical, but maybe spiritual. Something that you've been attacked with, or kind of something, I'm not saying like a sin you struggle with, but something that you're not strong in an area and you need help with. And you can't do it without the Lord. And I think that just magnifies, and he uses that to humble us and to keep us needing him. So, yeah, just something to reflect about. And so, again, I'm hoping my audio works better on this video. so you can actually hear my mic as I'm playing. Another thing too, man, it's so weird. This morning, I don't think I'm ever going to do it again, but I was drinking coffee as I was recording. You could hear, like, I must have had my mic turned up way too loud, because you could hear, like, every single gulp I made, and that was so annoying. And, yeah, it was getting on my nerves listening to myself, and I can't imagine how annoying it would be for someone else to be listening to me. So, yeah. But anyway, so picking up where we left off yesterday, we just rescued John Marston, and now we're back at the camp trying to just survive. And so let's go ahead and let's get the show on the road. Okay, and again, guys, if after watching this, you have any suggestions on my audio, like, hey, you probably need to turn it down, turn it up a little more, adjust it. I'm going to be listening to those things and trying to figure them out, but suggestions are always welcome, so I would appreciate any feedback possible. So I'm going to try to play this, though, like, I haven't played it before. But, yeah, I have, so.
We're gonna starve to death up here, Mr. Morgan.
We're okay.
We have a few cans of food and a rabbit. For what, 10, 12 people? When I was in the Navy.
I do not wish to hear about what you got up to in the Navy, Mr. Pearson.
We were stranded at sea for 50 days.
And you unfortunately survived.
When we ran away from Blackwater, I wasn't able to get supplies in.
Well, when government agents are hunting you down, sometimes shopping trips need to be cut short. We'll survive. We always have. If needs be, we can eat you. You're the fattest.
I sent Lenny and Bill hunting, and they found nothing.
Nothing.
I'm more into book learning than hunting. Bill's a fool. Unless those mountains are full of game that want to read, ain't no wonder they found
enough of this. We'll go find something. Come on, Arthur.
Wait a second. Hold on. Here. You're gonna need something to eat out there. Assorted, salted off. Starving will be preferable.
Come on, let's go.
You can't go hunting. Look at your hand.
I can't stay here listening to you two. Look, if there's game in those hills, I'll find it. And you can kill it.
You need to rest, Charles.
You think this is rest? Come along. Here, you take this. I can't use it, and you'll have to.
Oh, you're joking.
Use a gun, and we'll scare off every animal for miles around. You're never too old to learn, I imagine. Come on, this way.
All right. Let's go, boy.
How are you holding up, Charles?
I'm okay, apart from this hand. Stupid mistake.
Still bad?
It'll be fine in a day or two. I just can't pull a bow right now.
Sure hope I can. Never really got the hang of it.
You'll be fine.
So, you reckon we're gonna find something to kill that ain't an O'Driscoll?
Huh. There's meat up here for sure. Pearson doesn't know what he's talking about. Now the weather's eased off a bit, they'll be needing to feed. We'll head up this way, find some higher ground.
Been a wild few days, all right. Careful. That ride north from Blackwater, getting stuck in the storm. John back in.
You've had a lot put on you. I wish I could have done more.
I didn't mean it like that. Just a lot to think back on.
I still don't really know what happened on that boat.
Me neither.
Probably something we don't want to know.
It sure weren't good.
It weren't good, I tell you what, that gun. Really long cutscene. The controls are so hard in this sometimes.
Has deer been here recently?
How can you tell?
How can you not?
Idiot!
You're gonna need the bow. Don't leave it on your horse. A gun will scare everything around.
So, maybe not.
Focus. It's easier in the snow, but once you get your eye in, you'll be able to. But nearly as well in grass and woods.
Okay. So daggone slow. I see one.
Down there. You see him? Quick, get that bow out, Arthur. Try to hit him in the neck or head. Quick and clean. You can pull back quite hard. You'll feel when it's too much.
Yeah, because they're... want me to shoot it in the head, and that's not at all what they teach you to do in hunting.
Now let's try for another.
It is just a game, Corey.
Well, you know what? Whoops. It's so hard to see. Oh, whoops. Stop moving.
Unlucky. Take your time.
Give me that arrow back. Out of its misery. My bad, dear. I'm sorry.
Poor thing. Done.
Okay. My bad, dear. I just suck. Come on, boy. Alright, you can move a little faster than that, man. Oh, come on.
Can't you control that thing?
Move.
Nice work, Arthur. Should be enough meat here.
Thanks.
To keep us all fed for a few days. You found him. I knew you'd be okay with that bow. It's easier when they ain't shooting back.
We've seen enough of that.
Considering how things were looking a couple of days back, well, maybe our luck's finally on the turn.
Seems to me we should be putting our effort into getting off this mountain now.
Soon. People are still weak, and you've seen how snowed in those wagons are. They ain't going nowhere until we get some more thaw.
You're probably right. And even if we do get off here, what then? We still have a big price on our heads.
This is a big country. We'll find somewhere to lie low. Dutch and Jose will have a plan. Since we fled Blackwater, we give the camp cook 5 minutes to grab the essentials and go, and he doesn't even bring a crumb of food.
Good that we caught more than one. A lot of mouths to feed.
And that girl from the ranch now, too. But not sure she'll be eating much.
She has a wild look in her eye.
You would, too. She lost her husband, her home, everything she had.
So what do we do with her?
Once we get out of here and we're back on our feet, we'll see. She might have family somewhere.
So it was O'Driscoll's you ran into there?
Yeah. Last thing we was expecting.
What is it with the O'Driscoll's?
You ain't dealt with them? I suppose. Hell, we ain't run into them much the last 6 months. I guess because they've been over this way.
Yeah. I've heard a lot of talk about them.
Well, we've been scrapping over scores with them for years. Big gang. Nasty sons of bitches. Their leader, Combe, and Dutch go way back. And not in a good way. A proper blood feud.
Watch out.
All right, now to recreate what I did earlier. I've got to do this because that's what I did this morning.
Real hungry. Stay well back.
No.
Storms like this are the worst for animals that sleep all winter. That's a bad idea. Have you seen the size of it? What are you doing? Shoot!
Run! No! That's exactly what happened before. Alright. Just being faithful to the first video. Oh no. I gotta set this. This drives me nuts. I want to show me where to go.
With us now? 5-6 months? Something like that. Bet you didn't expect this. What? Any of this? The Blackwater mess? Being up here? Stay with me! Arthur.
Stay with me! No.
What was you talking
about? I've been in this gang longer than you, man. Yeah, I'm tired of you. Tired of your face.
I did that for a long time. I'm done with it. Always wondering if someone's gonna kill you in your sleep. I still wonder that most nights. I reckon you're okay. This suits me. Sure, I could fall in with another gang, but Dutch. You know, Dutch is different. Oh yes, Dutch is certainly different. He treats me fair. Most of you do. And for a fellow with a black father and an Indian mother, that ain't normally the case. Well, we need you now.
We ain't no prejudice around here, boy.
Good. And how long have you been with these boys? Why ain't you run off?
Me? Oh, 20 years, something like that. Since I was a boy.
20 years?
Yeah. Taught me to read. John, too. Tell me a few other things, and then Hosea.
Now, I don't know how things work in this, and I don't remember the first game all that clearly. But, are him and John related? Or are they not of any relation? I cannot remember.
Something happened to the Count.
Same with Bill and Brown Jack. He's a drunk, miserable bastard, but...
Alright, let's go a little faster, please.
I hope they all make it.
I tried to ride the Count once.
Can't remember what the... what it is for hitching.
Brought some food back, boys!
I'm gonna hitch time over here.
Come on, let's get these over to Pearson.
Thank you for showing me how to use the
study my horse.
I only showed you a little. It takes a lifetime of practice to master.
Not a bad haul, boy. Well, well, well.
Take that, you big boy.
What a surprise. Find a camp rat loitering around in the kitchen.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? I feel like we haven't spoken for days.
I do my utmost to avoid.
Why, he loves me, really. It's his sad way of showing affection.
No, it isn't. Now shoot, get lost.
Well, see you gents later.
See, you got on just fine. Charles is a wonder.
Have a drink, boys. You earned it.
Jesus, what is that?
Dagger.
Sir. The only thing.
Keeps you sane, it does.
Yes. Oh. Seems to have done a treat on you. You go rest that hand, Charles.
We'll be fine in a few days.
You mind helping me with the skinning, Mr. Morgan? It's easier if we do it together.
I'll get to skin you.
You're always one with the jokes, aren't you? Come on.
This really isn't a job for a man with a burnt hand. I'll see you both later.
You skin that one you dumped on the floor there.
Hey, said to drop it. At your feet. That's what I did. Yeah, like skinning would be that quick.
Huh. Not too bad, Mr. Morgan. Yeah. They always said you were a butcher. You know, you could trade these or sell these in pretty much any town. If you're looking to make a legitimate bit of money, of course.
Right now, I'm just looking to get off this mountain alive.
Well, if you catch anything else, you bring it to me.
Sure.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Heck, Arthur Morgan's first decent bit of hunting after all these years.
Yeah, well, we're on the run now. Everyone's got to do their bit to survive. Just make a good stew. Folk need it. It's been a tough few days.
Yes. I am gonna actually save another one. Oh, well, never mind. It won't let me. Wouldn't let me do that earlier, too. I don't understand why it's not allowing me to save whenever I want. Let's look again. If I go back, it's grayed out for me to do it. I don't understand why. Okay, whatever. Got a problem?
Hey, look out, Alvier.
Up with you boys, because I thought you liked action. A couple of days on the lam, you lot have all turned yellow.
Apart from you, of course.
Shut up, Micah. I ain't never seen so many long faces.
I guess folks miss them.
I fell, but when I fall, I don't want no fuss.
When you fall, there'll be a party.
Party. Probably.
Uh-huh.
Funny, huh? Sure.
I cannot stand that guy.
Being laughed at by the likes of you two.
Stop it! Now! You fools punching each other when Como Driscoll's needing punching hard. You want to sit around waiting for him to come find us? All of you, we got work to do. Come on.
Are you sure about this, Dutch?
Yes.
You sure about this, Dutch, David?
We hardly back on our feet yet.
And the last thing we need is to get bushwhacked by Como Driscoll. Let's go.
I know you hate him, Dutch.
He's here for us.
I doubt that.
No, you're just doubting me.
I would never doubt you, Dutch. You.
I love you, Dutch.
Revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
This is the right call, Arthur. Take this. And this is about more than revenge for business long ago. They were talking about trains and detonators here. Cole always had good information. Come on.
And you think now is the right time to hit a train?
Now you might fancy living on deer piss and rabbit shit.
Love it.
I'm getting too old for that life. Mr. Matthews, Mr. Smith, Mr. Pearson, would you please look after the place? There are O'Driscolls about. Yeah! Southwest, right, Arthur?
Yeah. He said follow the main trail southwest. They're camped near some lake.
Okay, let's go find these bastards before they find us and rob this score they're planning.
And a long cutscene.
What's that? Tracks. Horses, quite a few of them.
Excuse me.
As far as I can tell, the only fools out here are us and them. They must be this way.
You good, Dutch?
Of course. Listen, I know you don't think much of my ideas recently, but this is the right move.
Okay. You know I got your back.
I learned a long time ago that you hit Como Driscoll. Wait for him, and people you love will die.
This feud between you and him needs
to be put to rest, one way or another.
It will be.
Some things I can forgive, others I can forget. What he did to Hannibal, I can't do neither.
You killed his brother, Dutch.
Yes, I did. And I hope the bastards will be reunited soon enough. That's how this'll end.
I wonder what he did to Annabelle. Who Annabelle is.
Let's cut up here and take a look. They said it was near the lake, so we must be close. Ha! Hold up here.
Whoa.
Whoa. All right, gentlemen. This is it. Are we goddamn ready?
Ready, Dutch.
Good. Now, Mr. Morgan and I, we're gonna head up here a little, see if we can't get a sense of the layout of the camp. Mr. Williamson, Mr. Bell.
Guy's a little albino horse.
Position just outside the camp. Mr. Summers, Mr. Escuela, you two, hold position here. Let's go.
I thought you were going with Dutch.
I am. I gotta say bye to my boy. He's a good boy. I'm coming. Can't go any faster though.
So,
yeah, that's him.
Who's he talking to? He don't seem very happy.
No.
They leaving?
Seem to be. Should we go get them?
No. Cone can wait. Best to get some of them out of there.
Right, let's get a layout.
And much less fun to rob him and his score if he never finds out about it. Come on, let's get down there.
I was trying to do it earlier and it wouldn't let me.
You two get up there and keep us covered.
You got it, Dutch.
All right, buddy. See you later. If I don't die.
Take the same path down as Bill and Micah. Like you said, revenge is a luxury we can't afford.
Yeah, just wasn't sure you agreed with me.
Arthur, have you completely lost faith in me? Our needs right now are supplies, equipment, and a way out of here. Everything else, including Combe, can wait.
Okay.
There's enough of those bastards down there to deal with as it is. Now come on.
I'll go in front of you, boss. I'll protect you. Okay, can we move a little faster, please?
Oh, I see how it is.
It's steep here. Careful.
I'm gonna sprint. These graphics are really good. Who took it? I tell you what. I tell you what.
Maybe I should take the lead on this. They're going to be gunning for you.
They ain't got me yet.
No, but the way our luck's been running.
Hush.
Yeah, it's been crap.
Take this if you want.
Just make the call. You want to take the lead? Go.
So we got everything we need.
Okay, I'll go first.
He's enjoying that too much. Whoops. My aim weren't such trash. Oh yeah. Get him, boy. Right in the face. Boom. Oh, to the right. Really? Whoops. Shot his head off, but... Move, dang it! Oh. That's what I thought, boy! Shoot your eye out, kid! Oh.
Oh shit! Look out!
Oh daggum! Really? Oh, that didn't work. I say we defend here.
Office, they come out of the
Oh, that would drive me nuts. Die, die, die. Searching these bodies. They got money and all that stuff on them. I'm taking it. I did that in the first game. I'll do it in this one. So, I think I answered my own question, though, of earlier. I do not think they are related, actually. Because I'm pretty sure his name is Arthur Morgan. And John's is John Marston, so that kind of answers that question. Yes, we do. I got nothing but time. I'm getting my money, man. I ain't leaving. Without my money's worth. You don't pay me enough, Dutch. I'm sure this is real fun for you guys to watch. Not good enough at editing yet either to filter it out. One more, I see. Give me that money. If I look, my satchel, valuables, documents, oh, only $9, I guess back then that was probably a lot of money though.
Good work, boys. Now, let's tear this place apart. Bill, go search that wagon there. Mike, search that building. Arthur, you take that building to the left. All right, man, quick. Find those detonators, explosives, anything you can.
Yeah, give me that chaw. Why can't I? Oh, I can't carry any more tuned back. Dadgummit. What am I going to do without my chew? Ooh, I got two doll hairs. Oh, yeah, got me some of that Kentucky bourbon. Come on now.
See, I missed all this the first time I played this. Guess when you actually pay attention. I just suck! Give me that dynamite. Hey,
this looks good. What do you think, Bill?
Looks fine. Smells good.
Come on.
Did we get everything?
Think so, boss. Found this on one of them.
Thank you.
This is perfect.
Oh, yeah. Interesting. This is something about the train they was gonna rob. A Mr. Leviticus Cornwall. Mount back up. Let's keep moving. All right. Let's get out of here. Proud of you, boys. All of you.
Thanks, Dad.
Good work, fellas.
Not bad for some starving down and outs. They can pummel us hard as they like. But we will always get back up and fight. That's who we are. Outlaws for life, fellas. Wait until we have John, Mac, Charles, and Sean back riding with us, and I believe, I know, they will all be back.
Well, you didn't get combed, but this hit will hurt him a lot more than any bullet in the head.
Especially when we rob this train, too.
Yeah, I guess we'll see about that.
Oh, indeed, we will.
You know, he'll come after us.
Oh, of course he will, just like all the rest. But we're gonna stay a step ahead of them. Make sure we always know where they are before they know where we are. We allowed ourselves to get a step behind in Blackwater. That won't happen again.
Okay, my controller just acted really stupid, but... Come on, boy. Man, I got him the first time earlier.
What the hell did I do?
I'll lock on you. That's what I did. Don't mind if I do. Let me see what you got, boy.
Just let me go. Come on.
Ooh, you got a health cure. I'll be needing that. It's getting night, too, boy.
Comfortable enough for you? What's your name, boy?
I don't know.
I don't know, man. Something.
You to save your breath for screaming.
No, please.
Don't do it, mister.
I hardly know him.
What the heck? I swore I just heard a sound back there.
You're hurting me.
Shut your mouth, you little shitter. I will shut it for you. Now tell you what. Yeah, I accidentally did it to a previous guy I interrogated. I meant to let him go, but I punched him so hard I killed him. I killed him! Believe me, I'm trying to get you back.
Introduce you to the boys.
Don't hurt me, please.
Oh, don't worry. They're real nice.
Yeah.
Huh. You found a little shit, did you?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
I got him.
Very good. Welcome to your new home. Hope you're real happy here.
You want me to make him talk?
Oh, no. Now all we'll get is lies. Uncle, Mr. Williamson, tie this maggot up someplace safe. We get him hungry first. I got a saying, my friend. We shoot fellas as need shooting, save fellas as need saving, and feed them as need feeding. We are gonna find out what you need. I can't believe it! An O'Driscoll in my camp.
I ain't an O'Driscoll, mister. I hate that fella.
Oh, whatever you say, son. Well done, Arthur.
I'm just sorry we missed out on Cole.
Oh, there's time enough for that. Now, I gotta figure out if we can hit that train.
Okay.
Yes, boss. Few days later. Dear Diary.
It's been a bad few weeks, but Dutch being Dutch, he is busy making plans, and Dutch being Dutch, those plans involve robbery and dreams. Well, I thought you was reading him his last rites. Now I see you're introducing him to your other passion.
I'll mind you to show me some respect, Mr. Morgan.
Mind away, Reverend. You still here, then?
I owe you.
Yeah. And you'll pay me. But for the moment, just rest.
Arthur! I think it's time for the train.
You want me to come?
Of course I do, but... look, Ash.
I was always ugly, Dutch. It's just a scratch.
Don't lie still, son. Hello, Abigail.
Dutch.
Jackie.
The boy wanted to see you, John.
He's seen me now. Or what's left of me. What about you?
Guess I was hoping to see a corpse.
Bide your time. You'll see plenty of them.
You're a rotten man, John Marston.
He is an idiot, Abigail. We all know it. Now, railway men. Bill, now you ride ahead and set the charge at the water tower just before the tunnel.
Ain't a problem. Why are we doing this? Weather's breaking. We could leave. I thought we was lying low.
Yeah, come on.
What do you want from me, Hosea?
I just don't want any more folks to die, Dutch.
We're living, Hosea. We're living. Look at me. We're living. Even you. But we need money. Everything we have's in Blackwater. You fancy heading back there?
No. Listen, Dutch, I ain't trying to undermine you. I just want to...
But I am.
Plan, ...which was to lie low, then head back out west. Now, suddenly...
Don't
about to
ever...
...train.
What?
Speak over me again.
Leviticus Cornwall's no joke, Dutch.
Well, who is Leviticus Cornwall?
He's a big railway magnet, sugar dealer, oil man.
Well, how good for him. Sounds like he has more than enough to share.
Dutch.
Gentlemen, it is time to make something of ourselves. Get your horses ready. We have a train to rob. Everyone ready? All right, let's head out.
All right. If it'll let me save. No. It will not.
Okay. Okay, gentlemen. Listen up. All of you. According to the information so kindly provided to us by...
Okay, let me see if... When the last save was... 1749. It's 5:44 ago. Alright, I'm gonna try a little bit far. I need to be getting off of. Probably get right before we get into a fight or something.
The train will be coming north from Big Valley. We're gonna pick it off after it crosses the border into the Grizzlies. There's a raised spot there that should give us good vantage. Charles, you'll keep lookout for any outriders. How's that hand, by the way?
I'll be fine.
Good. I'll take the driver and engineer, then run point. Lenny and Javier, you two take the front cars, deal with any guards. Arthur and Micah, you head straight for the back. That's what we're after. Mr. Cornwall's private car.
You and me, Morgan.
Great.
Have you got a problem with that?
Not if you keep your head for once.
You worry about yourself, huh?
Enough! After Bill blows the tracks, we're gonna need to move fast. Is everyone clear on what they're doing?
Yep.
Crystal.
Yes, boss.
Good.
Back of the train.
Come on. Let's ride.
Go on now, get. These cutscenes. Yep.
Out of the snow, finally.
Feels good, doesn't it? But we need to get this done fast. Now it's thawing. Before anyone gets up here after us. Oh, look at you boys. See? This is what I call a crew. Micah Bell, Charles Smith, Arthur Morgan, Javier Escuela, and what about young Lenny here? Always the first man on his horse.
Just happy we're back at him, Dutch.
You sure you're ready for this, kid?
Of course I'm ready.
Just stay calm. Keep your eyes sharp. That goes for all of you. No mistakes. Not again.
So we do this, then we go back to Blackwater to collect.
How many times are you gonna ask the same question, Micah?
That's a lot of damn money to leave sitting for too long.
It would be crazy to go back there now. The place will be swarming with Pinkertons.
We go back when I say we go back, and that's the end of it. Money's safe. You'll just have to trust me. And if the O'Driscolls are right, there'll be a stack of railroad bonds on this trip.
Whoa.
Good money, once we work out how to cash them. There's the water tower. Hold up here on the ridge. Whoa.
Oh.
Is Bill there?
Yeah.
You want to head down, see how he's getting on?
Okay.
Okay, boss.
Yeah.
Yeah. How you doing, buddy?
Yeah. I'm
sure?
Of course.
Can I help a little?
All right. Go ahead and set up the detonator by those rocks over there.
Okay, sure.
Now just unspool the wire and then attach it to said detonator.
Man, that's... Okay.
Good.
All right. That should do it. You head back up to the others. I got it from here.
Mistakes. What's going on?
He says all fine.
We'll soon find out.
Everything okay?
I think so.
Okay, cover your faces. Train should be here any minute now. Gentlemen, it's time. Good luck, all of you. You all know what to do.
Here we go. Shit, no, what? God!
Oh, you have got to be kidding me.
Where did you find that?
Moral.
You said it was fine.
It's my fault.
Come on!
You're pathetic. You know that?
Alright, I think that's a good place to end it if it'll let me. Oh man, I don't understand this sometimes. Why will it not let me save? That is so annoying. Oh.
Oh shit. Help.
I think I'm gonna let you fall.
I got you. Now stop yelling.
Oh, whoops. Oh, we're killing them now? I didn't think we were actually going to kill the people. Oh, shoot! Yeah.
We gotta hurry. We have to stop.
We'll ignore that part. Oh, really? Gotta reload first. Ain't no good without no shot. Oh! We got old Abraham Lincoln over here fighting me. Come on, Abe. You wanna go, boy? You wanna go? Yeah, square up, boy. Bye. Oh. All right. That's right. Right in the eye. Oh. How'd I miss? All these bastards must be gone somewhere. Right in the neck. This is a setup. Oh, what are you doing, man? Where is he at? Oh. Man, I suck. Oh. Good shooting, kid. I can see now why the O'Driscolls brought so many boys up here for this. Arthur, get over here. Okay. Can I save this yet?
You two all right?
Yes. Let's get the money and go.
We got some fellas holed up in this last car.
Ah, shit.
What are you boys planning on doing in there? Listen to me. We don't want to kill any of you.
Any more of you.
I give you my word, but trust me, we will.
I work for Leviticus Corps.
Come on, boys.
We got our orders.
Okay. You asked for it.
We ain't
Five,
opening this door.
4, 3, 2, 1. Seems our friends have gone deaf. Wake them up a little. That's enough. Mr. Williamson, give Mr. Morgan and Mr. Smith some dynamite. You two boys go blow that door open.
Now, don't matter too much to us, but you boys in there might want to take a step back.
Seems good enough.
Here we go.
I'll light the fuse.
Unless you got a death wish, I'd step back, fellas.
Kaboom!
That train.
Get
this place. It's like a palace.
Well, now I've seen everything. Oh, you two got the safe? I'll search the rest.
Oh, yes. Should be easy as cake. You're just gonna stand there, kid. Pour me some brandy, will ya?
I'm parched. Shut up. Me and Arthur did all the work.
Yeah, kid did good. Didn't see you rushing to jump.
Dear Mr. Cornwall, we are yet to receive payment of $2,000 for the initial phase of exploration at the Wapiti Indian Reservation. I'm Marino, as agreed in the contract between Cornwall Kerosene and Tar and the Leland Oil Development Company, dated November 9, 1898. On receipt of the funds, we will proceed with phases 2 and 3 of the project and present you with a detailed report of your findings within the month. Of our findings within the month. Yours respectfully, James Critchley, Head of Accounts, Leland Oil Development Company.
Just a pile of papers.
Bonds?
I don't think so. Here, make yourself useful. At least we all know you can read.
Give me those.
Give me a cigar. Railroad, oh, I got too many.
Tax, invoices, blah, blah, blah. You got anything?
Not really. Sugar imports from the Spanish West Indies?
A lot of sugar?
Dear Leviticus, thank you for the telegram and your continued interest in the Jameson Mining Company. However, any news you have received of mismanagement or financial difficulties at the mine in Annsburg are simply fake, and I would urge you to question your sources. The coal industry is quite different from the oil industry in a number of ways, so I certainly remain open to a business meeting at your convenience to exchange ideas and educate each other on our respective areas of corporate expertise. I would also be delighted to host you in Annsburg and give you a personal tour of the mine and its associated facilities. I look forward to further correspondence. Yours sincerely, Archibald Jameson. So far, it looks like a bust. Ooh.
How's it looking in there?
This looks like something.
Think I got him?
Nice. Well, thank God. Come on.
Premium cigarettes. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Piggy Hill. All right.
What did you find?
These bonds. They worth anything?
Oh sure. Bearer bonds. I think we can probably sell these pretty easily. Well done. Now would you get rid of all of this?
Train?
Yeah. Get it out of here.
What about them?
What do you think?
I don't know.
It's up to you. Kill them, leave them here, take them with you on the train. Just make sure they don't send no folk after us.
Okay.
See you back at camp. When you get back, we'll be moving on. The rest of you, let's ride.
All right, I'm not gonna kill you like I did. Oh, whoops. I didn't mean to.
I hear so much as a footstep from this car. You'll end up like all your friends out here.
My bad. Didn't mean to shoot. I just wanted to aim my gun. Yeah, good boy. Alright, really? I gotta do all this? Come on. Hopefully it'll let me save the dang game now. I'm having fun, but I got a wife I gotta hang out with. I'm assuming that's auto-saving. Hopefully, I swear, if I'm done recording and there's no volume, game volume, oh, I will not be happy. Mary Beth, come on now, girl.
So, are we getting out of this hellhole?
We're gonna try. Weather seems stable.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
We got money in our pocket.
And we just robbed the Leviticus Cornwall train.
The question is, where now?
I know this country a little. I told you, we should set up camp in Horseshoe Overlook near Valentine. We'll be able to hide out there no problem, as long as we keep our noses clean.
Well then, let's go. Clean noses and everything else. Arthur, you're in that one. Bring Hosea. I know you two like to talk about the good old days and what's gone wrong with old Dutch.
They do have some pretty cool cutscenes in this, I will say. They are pretty neat. You know all this. This is a fancy loading screen.
Lenny! Micah! Get over here!
Yes, boss.
You two ride up ahead. Make sure there's no surprises. We've had enough of those.
Me? With the boy?
Just go.
Come on, kid. You can buy me a whiskey.
Oh my goodness. Let's see if I can't save now. You have got to be kidding me.
We can handle it. All right, Charles, you and me hold the thing up while you try and put the wheel back on, Arthur.
You still strong enough to hold up a wagon?
Shut up.
I'm just saying.
Well, say less. Pick the wheel up.
So useless after all.
Not quite.
Uh-oh. Do you got some engines up there?
What do you think?
Yes.
If they wanted trouble, we wouldn't have seen them.
Okay, you can get it.
Poor bastards.
Yes, they can see you. Hold on, I'm almost done.
Let's not push our luck.
What happened?
Well, get in.
tell you.
All right, can I please save it? Okay, they need to fix that in the game. Seriously, this I've tried saving I don't know how many times. Don't give me a save mechanic if you're not gonna let me use the save mechanic. What's the point of it if I can't save it wherever I want? Why? Because if I go in here, my last auto save is probably gonna be like, yeah, it's 5 minutes ago. That doesn't make any sense. Why give me the option then? That doesn't make any sense.
So, yes, the Indians in these parts got sold a very raw deal. This is the heartlands we're going to. Good farming and grazing country, they lost it all. Stolen clean away from them, it was every blade of grass. Killed or herded up to the reservations in the middle of nowhere.
Different from anywhere else.
Well, maybe it's not.
All right, I think I'm actually going to end it there. I'll just backtrack a little bit. I'm going to try and edit out some stuff, so yeah. But all right, guys, thanks for watching. If you liked it, hit the like button, subscribe, and tell other people about this channel. It's just starting out, so I know I have a lot to work on, so I'm going to work on that, but yeah. I appreciate you guys watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Again, if you have anything that I could be praying for you about, any comments, suggestions, drop them in. All right. Thanks, guys. Bye.